open the door, Johnny.
Careful there, Doc. Reckless behavior like that couldn't be good for a surgeon.
So did you have fun, Johnny?
You're gonna have to be more specific than that.
I warned you about Lisa. I told you your little game was gonna end up dangerous. Someone's gonna end up dead.
Well, you look healthy to me, and Lisa was just here. And believe me when I say that she was more than healthy. From what I understand,
Robin's
okay. A four-year-old
boy is dead, Johnny. Lisa was so desperate to get her hands on that syringe, she tried to run Robin off the road. She ended up hitting and killing Elizabeth Weber's little son, Jake. Blood's not only on her hands, Johnny, it's on yours, too.
Excuse me, can I have the Jaws and Jacks? Okay. Thank you. This time you won't get a free pass from Shady Brook. Hopefully you'll end up in prison where you belong.
Okay, well, what's got your paranoia in a twist now?
Well, you took the syringe from my locker.
If you say so, though, I doubt you have any proof.
You're right. I can't prove it. Was it worth killing a child over?
Excuse me?
Did you see him and just not give a damn?
Okay, I don't know what you're raving about, but I'm not gonna stand here.
You were tailing me on Lexington last night. That's the street where Jake Weber lived, where you hit him and he died.
Lisa ran over a little kid. Are you sure?
Police have forensics looking at her car as we speak. So, Johnny, was it fun? I mean, are you proud of yourself? Does she get extra points in your little game for killing a little kid? You're pathetic, Johnny. Was it worth it? Huh? Your game?
I had no idea this was gonna happen.
What the hell you didn't? How many times did I warn you? Lisa is dangerous. Might make a little bit more of an impression now, huh?
This is Elizabeth Weber's kid.
Yeah. Jake, come on. Say his name. Not a big deal if it was Robin, right?
No one was supposed to die, all right? This was supposed to be just a game. And if that little kid did die and it's my fault, then yeah, I'll carry that with me for the rest of my life.
Well, I hope so. I hope his face is the last thing you see before you go to sleep every night.
Yeah, but the cops, they don't have proof, right?
Of all the drivers under suspicion, Lisa's the only one crazy enough to kill a little boy and keep driving. You know, Johnny, you might not be charged with accessory, but this is just as much your fault as it is hers.
Have gone this far. You should have been stopped months ago, before you had the chance to kill an innocent four-year-old little boy.
Okay, you don't give up, do you? Of course I'm upset that Elizabeth lost her son, but pinning that on me? Okay, that's a stretch even for you.
You're not gonna get away with it this time. You know, it's so sick that your vendetta against me is so out of control that a child had to die at your hands.
I'm not gonna stand here and listen to this.
Don't bother running to cover up the evidence. The police have already impounded your car, and forensics are going over it as we speak. Any minute, you will be exposed for the evil woman that you really are.
Okay, you know what this is about? This is about you being jealous of me, right? You're so afraid of losing Patrick.
Jealous?
You're gonna accuse me of killing a child?
I am not jealous of you anymore, okay? Patrick and I are back together. Oh, you didn't hear that? Every dirty trick imaginable, and still you end up with nothing. Well, that's not entirely true, because you'll always have this one thing to carry with you. You will always be a child killer.
Look, I know you all.
You know what the most tragic part of all of this is?
The apology that you're gonna owe me when you realize that you're wrong about me again.
None of this ever had to happen. I didn't have to live in fear the last few months. Jake didn't have to die. You didn't have to throw away what was left of your sanity or ruin your career. Because what you've been chasing so relentlessly all this time was never yours to have. Patrick never wanted you.
His actions definitely showed otherwise.
What happened with you was a blip in our marriage. It's not going to have any long-lasting effect.
Okay.
And in fact, I think it made our relationship stronger, because now we know we can face and overcome anything together.
Oh, you're so delusional.
No, that would be you. And when they prove that you ran down Jake, you will be on your way to prison the way you so richly deserve.
You know what? Another thing you don't know about me? I never go quietly.
Where have you been?
Oh, jeopardizing my medical career, but it felt good. Hands a little sore, though.
Wait, what? Putting your fist through a wall or punching someone?
There you go. I simply went over to Johnny's to have a little conversation with him.
Right.
Truth is, I wanted to strangle him with my own hands. How many times did I warn Johnny about Lisa? And that his little game was gonna get somebody killed, where she ended up killing Jake.
Which she's denying, of course.
Robin, I keep thinking about Elizabeth. I mean, what if that was Emma?
I know. I'm trying not to think about that. I don't think I could survive that.
I don't think I'll ever forgive myself.
What happened to Jake wasn't your fault.
Kind of is. Lisa's only here because she's been coming after me.
But you can't blame yourself for how crazy Lisa is. That's on her. Go, Mac. Are you here for Lisa?
Yeah, well, I don't get some results, but I can't discuss it with you. We're going to get to the bottom of it, I promise. Excuse me.
Dr. Niles?
I assume you're the head of the committee here to frame me?
I'm here to inform you. The forensics on your car has been completed, and the results are conclusive. We have traffic camera footage of your car racing through the intersection of Lexington and Gable in pursuit of Robin. We're going to cite you for reckless driving. I guarantee we'll make it stick. However, forensics show that your car was undamaged. There's no trace of any DNA, no indication yours was the car that hit Jake Weber, so for now you're off the hook.
Come on, Mac, it doesn't mean she's not guilty. So what? She's got a car wash.
Look, the investigation is ongoing, all right? We still have three other suspect cars to investigate. If there's still no indication as to who's responsible, we'll continue to investigate Dr. Niles. I'll personally see to that.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that the commissioner's looking out for me, because it makes it so much easier for me to sue for harassment, malicious prosecution.
Try it. Please.
So, once again, this was just another episode of your wife's paranoid imagination.
You know, I've seen you cover your tracks so many times, it doesn't mean you're not guilty. You're the only one soulless enough to kill a little boy and duck responsibility.
Patrick, what does it have to take for you to realize that all I ever did was
no,
love you?
Lisa, nothing ever will change my opinion of you.
Patrick and I are signing out, but we're reachable.
Thank you. So you ready?
Yeah. I'm glad you suggested a walk with Emma. We have a lot of family time to make up for.
Yes, we do.